Rafael Fourquet, and this is a short introduction to the ReTest.jl package, which is a small testing framework for Julia. ReTest is essentially compatible with the test standard library, which means that you write tests for ReTest with the usual testset macro. The main feature of ReTest is that you can select only a subset of the tests that you want to run via, for example, a regular expression. So ReTest is mostly useful if your tests take more than a few seconds to run. So let's start with a small example showing the basics of ReTest. We create here a module with a function that we want to test. We do using ReTest and write our tests using the testset macro. We can see here that no test is run when the module is evaluated. In order to run the tests, you have to call the retest function. But let's get first a list of all the tests without running them by passing the dry equal true keyword argument. We can now actually run the test by calling retest without arguments, or we can select which test we want to run by passing, for example, a regular expression, which is matched against the description of tests. We can pass a string, which works very similarly. We can pass an integer ID, as shown by the dry mode. Or we can pass a list of filters. Okay, let's now use a real package to show some more features of ReTest. Assume that I wrote a new ren method for polynomials in the abstract algebra package, and I want to test my changes. Here is the test that I want to run and update. Typically, if I don't want to run all the tests in the package, which take about 10 minutes here, I will have to copy this test into the REPL like this. So of course here it won't work because the testRun method is not defined. So I could put this function in a setup.jl file, for example, and include this file in the REPL. But the workflow is definitely not very practical. For example, you have to keep in sync the test in the REPL and in the file. Another workflow is to delete temporarily all the tests which I don't want to run. But it's not exactly ideal either. So let's do it the ReTest way. We can just wrap the main run test file in a module. Use ReTest instead of test. And rename this file according to the module name. We can now load this file, for example, by updating the load path. And we will also be using revise. We can now run our test by passing a string to retest. We can now update the test. And rerun the test, letting revise do its magic. All right. A last bit of convenience is provided by the watch function. Watch takes the same arguments as retest, but reruns the test anytime a file is changed. So let's change the file and see that tests are rerun. All right, now we probably want to run more tests related to ren. So here we already have run test number 91, as shown by the green check mark, so we would like to not run it again. We could filter out this test manually by passing minus 91 to retest. But the more general option is to use the pass filter, which matches any test that already passed. If we write minus pass, we select only tests which have not already passed. Okay, so now Nemo depends on abstract algebra, so we would like to test our change against Nemo too. Let's assume that the maintainers do not want Nemo to depend on retest. So instead of locally modifying the files in Nemo, as we did in abstract algebra, we can use the hijack function, which will do that automatically for us. We just pass to it the Nemo module. Okay, Nemo tests are now loaded and we can run them as usual. Here we can see tests for both packages. If we want to run tests only for Nemo, we can pass a module to retest. Let's run test number 3. Let's update test number 3 and run this test again. Okay. As an experimental half-broken feature, the hijack function also accepts base as an argument or any standard library. But it's better to use the more specific hijack base function to load only a subset of the tests. For example, let's load the char.jl test file from base. That will create a new module in which we can, for example, run the first test. Let's update this test and run this test again, checking that revise still works. Yeah. Okay. That's it for today. Thanks for listening.